What is up, everybody, and welcome back to Lesser Athletes. My name is Chadwell, and today, like always, an interesting video for you here on the channel. Today is who will dethrone all the current champions. A video we do every month here on the channel is usually the first or second week with the other two monthly videos that should be coming out here soon. Who will dethrone all the current champions? We have some changes, which I think we all love to see here on the channel. So there's not the same stuff that I'm just going to keep repeating, but you know how I do on the channel. We have the person who I think will dethrone and also a dark horse, aka probably the second person I see to really dethrone the champion. So I change those up a bit. I'm trying to think right now if they're all the same or not. I know some are the same, but a lot of them I changed for the sake of having some newness in this video. So let's get started with, of course, Cody Rhodes. We're going to go from SmackDown to then NXT to then Raw. Cody Rhodes is first. Interesting enough, I think obviously there's really just two people I think that could take it away from Cody Rhodes. Technically three, but for the longest time I've always had Randy Orton here. Today we're gonna have The Rock here. I think that The Rock is probably going to get this title here soon. I'm gonna be truthful. I could see a way where they really give it to him but here's the thing, I really debate on this. Would they really, and I mean really, give this title to The Rock, knowing he probably won't have a WWE kind of schedule for a little bit? I don't know. That means you're probably going to get a part-time kind of WWE champion like we usually do, but I don't know. I just don't see it. I really don't. I think with the workhorse mentality that Cody Rhodes has, feel like it's hard to say he's going to be somebody that they would give the title to. But for now, I'm going to say The Rock, because I think this whole narrative that they currently have with The Rock and Roman, I think it could play a big factor. My dark horse for this is, of course, Randy Orton, my runner-up. I've always had Randy Orton as who I think. I almost want to stick on to it, but I'm going to change it up for today. Probably will change it next month. Up next, we have Nia Jax. This is going to stay the same. I still think it's Tiffany Stratton. My dark horse is Charlotte Flair, but I really feel that Charlotte Flair is going to beat Nia Jax and Tiffany Stratton is going to cash in. Something like that. Tiffany Stratton's going to cost a Nia Jax, lose it, then Charlotte Flair is going to lose to a Tiffany Stratton. That's how I see it. Maybe if this match happens at Survivor Series, maybe it really is just Tiffany versus, or Nia Jax versus somebody else. But for now, this is how I'm seeing it. Up next, we have LA Knight. LA Knight's an interesting one. I'm going to stick with who I think that I've been saying is going to be Carmelo Hayes, because I just feel like Carmelo Hayes, for how young he is and how much of a mid-card he is right now and could elevate to a top-of-the-card guy, he deserves some gold or in some way. Put the fries in the bag, bro. You're washed. That's one of the funniest lines. I remember watching that live. Oh, my God. I started dying. I never in my life did I think Carmelo Hayes or this line gained. Put the fries in the bag, bro. You're washed. Would ever be just said in a WWE television kind of episode. Carmelo Hayes is still who I'm going for. I think his heel persona works. But I'm going, if I really want to put him on who I actually think is going to dethrone him. But I'm not. I'm putting Chad Gable. Chad Gable has been the guy I have been kind of creating this idea that Chad Gable will you win the U.S. title by WrestleMania next year. Because I think with LA Knight, makes a lot of sense, top guy. You know, babyface, everyone loves him. If we're looking at superstars, not branded, not looking at only brands, but we're looking at all WWE superstars, an American guy who's a big heel, who people want to win a title, that's Chad Gable. You can't tell me a Chad Gable heel versus babyface LA Knight does not make sense. You know, you could tell me it's not going to happen. I could agree. I can somewhat agree because different brands. But now it's WrestleMania time. So we could really see this change. I think a Chad Gable sense is really just kind of makes a lot more sense. It could happen because who else said LA Knight other than Carmelo Hayes? And Carmelo Hayes is a little too obvious in my opinion at this point. Chad Gable I really like. Up next, we have Tama Tonga and Tonga Loa, the Bloodline, who I think I changed it up. Going with Motor City Machine Guns. I think they're going to win some gold immediately coming to WWE. Would actually make the really tag team kind of division, I feel like, feel really good with them. And with them going to SmackDown officially. I'm recording this before the Raw and the SmackDown of this upcoming week. I'm recording this Sunday. So, you know, I haven't seen anything yet. And let's see how their debut goes, but I'm expecting a pretty good debut. Dark Horse. I'm going with the Creed Brothers. If, you know, Chad Gable does go to SmackDown, I'm going to say the Creed Brothers could win some gold as well. Maybe the Bloodline holds us on for a little bit, but maybe, you know, they get dethroned by the new Bloodline instead, or the old Bloodline instead. We'll have to see. I have a hard time seeing them hold these titles to WrestleMania, but maybe they actually do. So we'll have to see. Up next, we have Bianca Belair and Jade Cargo. Who do I think? I'm still going Pure Fusion Collective. I've always said Pure Fusion Collective. I don't think that they're going to win. I don't think Damage Control wins these tag titles on this upcoming Raw. I do believe that Pure Fusion Collective could have a really good chance at winning it if they want to build this stable. My dark horse for this, and what I could see happen at WrestleMania or another PLE, so that Bianca and Jade could turn back into solo or could really get their one-on-one feud going, is Bianca. I said Bianca Lynch. Oh my God. Becky Lynch and Lyra Valkyria. If they would want to go the route of potentially having these two go on their separate solo ends, I would understand. But you could maybe get a team that is valuable enough in a Becky Lynch and Lyra Valkyria. Because right now for Lyra, there's nothing going on. Becky's kind of, you know, in technically retirement, but I think she will come back at one point. I don't really know what those two could do when it's come back, when they come back for these titles. I could see both of them kind of teaming up and really becoming a good team that could maybe later on become a feud. And right now it would be get these tag titles. Up next, we have Trick Willie. Two-time Trick Willie. This is honestly kind of cringe that I'm saying this. Anyways, Trick Williams, who do I think? I think there's an obvious one, and that is Obafemi. I think Obafemi makes a ton of sense to get it. I think he will be the favorite to win it. Now, it kind of does suck because I did want Obafemi on the main roster. I think he was main roster ready for next year. I don't think if he wins NXT title that he would be main roster. So maybe they do wait a full another year and Obafemi is a big kind of eyeball on NXT. Who else do I think? I think Wesley. Even though they were hinting at it, I've always talked about how Wesley could have been somebody to take a title off with this huge heel persona. Maybe he does go for the NXT title. Maybe this is a way for him being a heel with a babyface Trick Williams. They have some good feuds. So I do like these two to win it. My dark horse, though, I don't know if it would happen. It would be kind of interesting if it does. And it would be interesting if he goes to NXT. Is Ricky Starks. If Ricky Starks does sign with WWE, do we see a way where Ricky Starks goes over to NXT? Do we see him maybe stay on SmackDown or Raw? I don't know. I think it is kind of difficult to really predict. But if he's still in his heel persona, we've seen how the success of AEW stars going to NXT in an Ethan Page. Could he win the title? I could see it. I think it would make a lot of sense. But for now, I'm going to say these are the guys that I do believe could take it off of Trick Williams. Up next, we have Roxanne Perez. This one's going to be obvious. It's really Julia. I've said it many, many times. Julia will win this title. But then my dark horse with this huge kind of sharks kind of swimming is Stephanie Vaquer. Vaquer. I always say Vaquer, and I know it's wrong. Vaquer. Here's the thing. It's kind of interesting. I feel like when you have these two powerful players now in this NXT title picture, it's kind of interesting to see what could happen with them. going to, you know, NXT right now, because it makes a lot of sense for Julia to win this title. I think that makes a ton of sense. But at the same time, could you potentially see a way where it's Stephanie instead? I don't know. I really don't know. Because they're going to have a feud. It's going to be a good feud. It's just interesting, man. This women's division is stacked. Like, these three should be having a title almost at all times. And now it's just so stacked. It's so stacked. Up next, we have Tony D'Angelo with the North American Championship. I technically called it when I talked about Obafemi losing in the past. I always said that Tony D'Angelo, I don't think I had it, but I did talk about it. Moving my chair up because I moved it back so far. I always talked about Tony D'Angelo. Tony D'Angelo was somebody that deserves some gold. I just didn't know if they would go for NXT title gold immediately or North American champion gold immediately. North American champion gold, I'm happy. And it makes more sense defeating in Obafemi. I mean, this pushes Tony D'Angelo to the roof, in my opinion. It's crazy how the Don slayed the ruler. And yeah, man, I'm happy for him. I really am. I think that he did deserve some gold, and he finally got it. I could see a way where he doesn't get the NXT title, or maybe Wesley wins it, and then maybe Tony D'Angelo wins it. I don't know. I don't think he'll go to the main roster this year during the draft. I think it will be next year, but maybe he does. We'll have to see. Who do I think is going to dethrone him? For now, it's kind of hard to predict. I'm going with Charlie Dempsey. I really like the Charlie Dempsey call, because I think Charlie is someone that, with his father being William Regal, has really shown some growth recently. I'm looking at heels. I'm looking at people that are heels that could take out a Tony D'Angelo. And Charlie Dempsey kind of plays this kind of interesting spot where you kind of, he's not really crazy heelish, but he is kind of heel. I like Charlie Dempsey as somebody, and he's really grown, especially with the Heritage Cup. Another dark horse is Lexus King, if you're talking about people with maybe possibly the best haircut ever and the best beard ever. Lexus King is up there, and I think Lexus King is somebody that does deserve some gold in WWE, and I feel like has proved that he could be someone that could be very great and could be someone that's very good for WWE and could really keep growing as a WWE talent with the North American Championship. Up next, we have Kalani Jordan. I'm going to keep saying it. Sol Ruka is my pick. I feel like they show Sol Ruka so much that she could literally go to the main roster at this point. Kind of kidding. Sol Ruka is very good in NXT, and Sol Ruka is going to be a WWE Women's NXT title holder here soon. I mean, she is fantastic. My dark horse now is going to be Delta, with her potentially coming to the WWE. I almost said for this, I was actually going to put Stephanie here, but I could see a way where they make Delta be the one to hold this title, and she is that heel that would make a lot of sense to beat a Kalani Jordan. I am happy that Kalani Jordan has been holding this for a while. This title is looking, you know, more legit every single day. I just could see a way that Delta is the one to take it off, to really grow this title and really become a bigger threat. Up next, we have the NXT title, tag team titles, Nathan Frazer and Axiom. They look incredible. I don't think there's anyone that can take these off of them, unless it's two people that haven't really made a team yet, which I can't really call that as well, which I think that's what it is right now. But this team is good. They are amazing. I'm going to be honest. My dark horse for this is going to be AOP still. I called it last time, but I think if AOP would come back to NXT to really grow and to really become a better tag team, to maybe use that momentum on the actual, what is it called? The actual main brands. Why can I not think about that? I can see them being the ones, but I just don't see anyone unless it's a tag team we haven't seen yet. Up next, We're back on Raw with Gunther. Who do I think? I still think John Cena. I think John Cena is going to be the one to dethrone Gunther at the end of the day. I don't see it being anyone other than John Cena, if you want me to be honest. You can say Braun Breaker, you can say all these people, but I just don't see it being... I don't see those being the ones to take down Gunther. I'm just going to be honest. Dark horse for this is going to be CM Punk. Could we see a way where CM Punk is the one to actually dethrone Gunther, hold the title, and then he start using that to go against some great opponents in the near future, maybe heading towards WrestleMania? Maybe. I also could see a world that maybe, you know, CM Punk's actually the one holding it after maybe around SummerSlam-ish. Maybe he's the one to take it off John Cena. Never know. I just believe that a Gunther, you know, title reign could maybe a CM Punk take out Gunther and really grow. And then Gunther goes on to have his own feuds. I don't know. I'd be interested to see, because right now I feel like Gunther with a championship makes more sense and CM Punk could make his feuds a little bit better. Up next we have Liv Morgan. Who do I think? It's of course Rhea Ripley. This will happen at either Saturday main event, Survivor Series, it won't happen. Saturday's main event, Saturday night main event, Royal Rumble, or WrestleMania. It's literally one of those three. It will not be at Elimination Chamber. So with that in mind, I just don't know when it'll happen. It'll happen. I just don't know when. My dark horse for this is going to be Raquel Rodriguez. Maybe if she holds it for a while, maybe Raquel Rodriguez somehow turns on Liv Morgan and then we have a match and Raquel gets it back and gets the goal that she would want. But I don't see it for now. For now, I just can't see it. I really just can't. Up next, we have Jey Uso. Jey Uso is an interesting one because I feel like Jey Uso, stay with me. Jey Uso could lose this immediately. I'm not going to lie, guys. I love Jey Uso. I have my own Jey Uso. Wait. There we go. Jey Uso glasses. That is my boy. I am a yeeter. I yeet all over myself every day as I can. I think he could lose this early because I did not expect this to happen with the Bloodline story going on. So happy he did. Deserves it 100%. I don't know. I wonder what's going to happen on Monday Night Raw. Obviously, Jimmy's going to be there in some case scenario probably to talk to Jey. I wonder what's going to happen then. But let's go with who I think. My number one guy to take it away from him is going to be Dominic Mysterio. Because I have said in a short on this channel, go watch it, please. That it makes too much sense for Jey Uso to be this crazy babyface and Dominic Mysterio to swoop up this championship and steal it away from him. It makes way too much sense. And it would elevate Dominic Mysterio to amounts you can ever imagine. Dominic Mysterio would be the heel winning by, you could say luck, but it could be little shenanigans. I love just the idea of Dominic Mysterio winning this championship. And I need this to happen. Now, because this just happened, I have three dark horses. Three. My first one is going to be Jacob Fatu / Solo Sikoa. Now, here's the thing. Do I think this happens? No. Do I want this to happen? Yes. If they would want to continue his Bloodline storyline and he has the IC title, I could see a way where they do Solo versus Jey or Jacob versus Jey entering WrestleMania for the title. And then we grow to that and that becomes like a huge storyline thing with the title. I could see that. At the same time, probably doesn't happen. Another thing, I could see Bronson Reed being the one to take it down. Because Bronson Reed has really grown as this crazy heel. He's been somebody that has looked dominant. People have been loving. He's just doing great work right now. And I think a title is kind of deserving for Bronson Reed. And I do believe that with him being an IC title like run this whole entire time, it's probably better to give it to him here soon. Finally, my last dark horse, sadly, I have to put. And I say sadly because I don't want this to really happen, is Braun Breaker. I would not be shocked if WWE is like, okay, we just gave Jey Uso his championship at Flowers. Let's have a rematch, and Jey Uso, you're going to lose it to Bron Breakker. I would not be shocked if that happens. I'm going to be 100%. Do I want it to happen? No. Do I think it could happen? Honestly, truthfully, yes. And I think it's probably going to happen. I could see a world where Bron Breakker has this rematch with Jey Uso, maybe at Crown Jewel, maybe earlier somehow, maybe. It's not at the next Monday Night Raw, I'm pretty sure. If they have something like this, you can call me crazy for calling it, but they give it back to Bron Breakker. Breakker holds it. The only reason why I say this is because it looked like Breakker was going to turn a little bit more babyface and look at kind of Gunther, and then all of a sudden he turned heel a little bit more again, and now could be something in the mix there. I don't know. We'll have to see, but I do think that's a big possibility. Up next, we have the Judgment Day. Who do I think is going to take the titles off of them? I'm thinking right now DIY, in the sense that they've had this kind of feud. It looks like DIY is going to break. Did I just say DIY? Oh my God, I'm a fraud. The New Day. I think it's going to be the New Day. The New Day makes a ton of sense. It looks like they're going to break up. They're not going to. Could be something with Big E, in my opinion. I think that the New Day kind of grows and really becomes this great kind of tag team again with these tag titles. I could see it 100%. Dark Horse is going to be the Lucha Bros. I think they go on Raw. Maybe they don't. Maybe this is a SmackDown team. But it'll be interesting to see when this happens due to, you know, all the things that's been going on currently with their contracts with AEW, how AEW exercise injury time. We'll have to see. But I would love the Lucha Bros to get a tag team title in Raw and really grow those tag titles and really defend the tag title, something the Judgment Day hasn't done yet. And I hope you guys enjoy. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.